Welcome back to BSLIVE. In this episode, I will be showing you how to connect the shape keys from this avatar, which is actually based on Enterprise, a Blender Guru, and connect it to Susan Head. So when the jaw is open, it's actually controlling this Susan. So how do we go about doing that? You can do this in multiple ways. You can use animation nodes, or you can just use Blender built-in drivers. So it's actually pretty simple. So I'm gonna leave that for now, and I'm gonna make another monkey head and just put it on the side. And for this monkey head, we're gonna scale it to 0.1, and then just Control A, apply the scale. So the scale is now reset to 1 or frozen to 1. And we want to control it with the jaw, okay? So if you are using animation nodes, we can actually get that pretty easily. So if you get the shape keys from Andrew's head here, you can get the shape keys, get the list, and get the index that you want to control the shape. You want the shape keys value to control Susan scaling. You can do that. So you can see here, you can easily use expression node, just grab the name or grab the value, and then you can see in the viewer here, if it's the jaw open shape keys, it's gonna have this changing value. Okay, so that's pretty clear enough, right? We can get the value. How do we connect it? If we are using animation nodes, we can easily, you know, just transform out. Oh, okay. Object transform output, and just grab this Susan and just use scale combine vector. So this is normally something that character rigger would like to have access to. So that's pretty easy. You can see Susan has scaling when Andrew is opening his mouth. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. This character, this scaling is controlled here. You can, of course, add a float math here. Just add it like a value of 0.2. So it's not growing to zero. It's not like that. We just offset it by 0.2 if you like to. If you want to do the same using driver, it's also kind of easy if you know how. So I'm gonna reset the scaling. So this, we want to control this one using drivers. This guy is actually controlled using drivers. How do we get this purple drivers? So first we select Andrew's head. We look at the jaw open. So we just right click here. Select copy as new driver. So now in the clipboard, Blender clipboard, we have these drivers that we can easily paste into. So right click, paste driver. So you can see, I think I might actually made a mistake. Select this value, right click, copy as new drivers, paste drivers. It's supposed to be like this. So now this scaling value is following Andrew's shape keys for jaw open. Okay, but you want to offset it, right? This is using Blender's own built-in drivers. So right click and edit driver. So we can actually quickly do something here, scripted expression, and just plus 0.2. So we probably need to do the same. Maybe we can just copy driver here, but just do this again. So the driver itself is very powerful. It takes some time to adjust to it if you are using it for the first time. But once you get what it can do, it's pretty easy and powerful. Scripted expression plus 0.2. So now we have all the three Susan head following this guy. So yeah, everything now is working properly. I don't know if I can, I wonder if I could connect it to my device and go live. My computer is pretty slow at the moment. Okay, now it seems to be working. The driver is actually working. Okay, the animation also is actually off. I need to activate it here. Okay, this is pretty cool. I wonder if we can actually do this. So while it's animating, Joe open and close. I wonder if I could record this. Maybe Blender has a way to do that from here. Scaling. Keyframe. Because this guy is now, the scaling is controlled using a driven key. And I want to motion capture that. Let me try something. If we use F3, take action. Wonder if this can work. No, it's definitely. Okay, it can work if I actually bake the animation here. So currently this one already have animations. I'm controlling this face while it's already have animations. It's slightly complicated, right? But you can actually add animation layers. So this this Suzanne is now is actually bake while still having set driven key, I think. Yeah, so you can definitely override and have animations to keyframe while it's animating in real time. Yeah, keying, maybe a layered recording should be one. I don't know how, but it's possible. Okay, so that's how we work with Shapekeys basically, and how we can use animation nodes to get information about the Shapekeys. And also we have this Andrew Price avatar. It's not looking, doesn't look like Andrew much, but we can control three Susan head using driven keys or animation nodes. Okay, hopefully you find this interesting. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you next time. Bye.